Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is our third press conference today. Soon you will learn about the course of voting and you will learn about the latest turnout data. It's a true pleasure to introduce to you the head of the NEC, Judge Sylwester Marciniak, deputy head of the NEC, Judge Zbigniew Cieślak, member of the NEC, Konrad Skłodowski, member of the NEC, Professor Balicki, and head of the National Electoral Office and secretary of the NEC, Minister Magdalena Pietrzak. Over to you, sir. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, the National Electoral Commission, on this day when we celebrate democracy, still has some very good news for you. Let me start with turnout data. Announcement of the NEC of the 28th of June 2020 on the number of people included in the lists of voters and the number of people to whom ballot papers were given until 5 p.m. in the presidential election scheduled for the 28th of June 2020. The NEC, based on data received from 25,423 District Electoral Commission, out of the total number of 25,423 Electoral Commissions. Again, we have 100% data, which is to inform you that in the presidential election as of 5 p.m. today, on the 28th of June, the number of people eligible to vote, i.e. the number of people included in the lists of voters, was 29,582,843 people. Ballot papers were given to 14,166,725 people eligible to vote, which accounts for 47.89% vis-à-vis the total number of voters. And again, let me emphasize that in 2015, the turnout at 5 p.m. was 34.41%. In the parliamentary election last year, at 5 p.m., the turnout was 45.94%. So still we are experiencing some upward trend. We might even notice that the 2015 presidential election ended up with 48.96% final turnout, and we are almost there as of 5 p.m. As regards information pertaining to provinces, we have three top players and three bottom players. The highest turnout was recorded in Mazovian province, 51.17%. Number two is Lesser Poland, 50.27%. And number three, Podkarpacki, Subcarpathian, 49.19%. The bottom players, Opolskie province, 42%. Number two from the end, Warmia, Mazury, 43.06. And number three, Kujawian, Pomeranian, 45.51. As regards aggregate information for major cities, still the highest turnout was recorded in Warsaw, 54.76%. Number two is Poznan, 53.21%. And number three, Zielona Góra, like before it was number two, now it's number three, 53.04%. In relation to the total number of voters, the highest turnout was recorded in Krynica Morska, Pomeranian province. It's still the top player, 73.54%. In relation to the number of people eligible to vote, the lowest turnout was recorded in Kolonia, Wolonowskie, Opolskie province, 31.21% of voters. Let me provide you with information about incidents related to election day. In comparison with 9 a.m. that we presented during the previous conference, we will now present you data as of 2 p.m. In total, the number of crimes and offenses related to elections was 242, which is 60 more than previously. And again, let me return to a question that was asked during our previous conference. The information about the death of a voter in the polling station was premature. Our senior voter lost consciousness but was taken to hospital, and we wish him all the best. With the high temperatures outside and the fact that we still have queues in front of polling stations, at least in several municipalities, each voter should remember to take a bottle of water with him or herself. Waiting outside in such high temperatures makes it really advisable. In terms of incidents, it turns out that Toruń was not a singular case. A similar incident happened in Warsaw. A driver of a vehicle, I'm not going to give you the car make, was trying to make a maneuver and hit a car of a different make. And alcohol was perceptible in the air breathed out by the driver. Police force were called in. A breath analyzer was made use of, and 1.28 milligram, that is 2.5 per mile of alcohol in exhaled air. It turned out during the intervention that the gentleman was the head of the regional electoral commission. He even had his badge in a visible place. He was immediately asked to resign. Another person was appointed to replace him. Moreover, we had some situations wherein it was suspected that a voter took out a ballot paper from the polling station. However, this is not yet clear. One voter came back after 1 hour, said that he forgot to put the ballot paper to the ballot box, but was prevented from doing so. Let me make voters very sensitive and aware of the following situations. In Poznań, a female voter reported that an unknown perpetrator misappropriated her ID. I'm sure you all went to the polling stations. Members of the commission do not require you to hand in your ID. It's just enough to show it. And the said female voter, once she came back home, realized that she most likely left her ID in the polling station. So please be mindful of your IDs and identification documents. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, now would be the time to ask them. Agata Załęcka, TVN. Good afternoon. Well, we had signals that in certain district electoral commissions already 90% of the ballot papers were handed out to voters. Can you confirm that? In how many places was that the case? How many polling stations run the risk of running out of ballot papers? And is that a good forecast for the final turnout? From each constituency received 90% of ballot papers. The sole exception were touristic spots where we immediately assumed that there will be a high number of voters, and it was known that more people added their names to the voters' lists. any commission when they notice that 60% of ballot papers were used is obliged to inform a regional electoral commission about that fact. If 80% were taken out, then they have to ask for replenishment, and then ballot papers are simply delivered. There is a specific procedure for that. Municipal offices hold ballot papers in their deposits and deliver them. The same goes for ballot boxes, which may be filled up to the brim. The office again has to deliver a spare ballot box. If I may add, the NEC has decided to print 100% of ballot papers, so we have exactly the same number of ballot papers as the number of voters. The sole matter right now is to make sure that they are where they are needed. We will react accordingly, observing the situation. Are there any further questions? Aleksandra Bielicka, Polish Press Agency. Good afternoon. Do you have any signals that we will prolong the election silence? Well, one sentence only. No, for the time being, there was no incident on the basis of which we could state that that might be necessary. It would have to be something extraordinary. For the time being, the answer is no, and let it stay that way. No regional electoral commission, no local representation office informed us about anything like that, and let's hope it stays that way. Do you have any further questions? If not, let me invite you to the final press conference today at 10 p.m. Thank you very much.